Now we will discuss aesthetics at home. What are the various things available to us that can increase the aestheticness of the home environment? For aesthetics, we have the flowers that can be used for creating a flower arrangement in the home that not only increase interest in the environment but also brings nature into the indoors. It will enlighten one's mood and increase the interest and breaks the monotony of the indoors. Let's discuss. So what is aesthetics? Aesthetics is an art to design and decorate the surroundings by using a set of principles that are concerned with the nature and appreciation of beauty. Importance of aesthetics in home. Aesthetics in home result in plan and organized arrangement. It creates a pleasant visual design. It prevents confusion and untidiness. It breaks the monotony in home designing by blending natural and modern design techniques in appropriate proportion. In this aesthetics, we will discuss flower decoration. As you can see in the pictures also, flower decoration not only increases the beauty but also enlightens one's mood and emotion and attracts one's desire and one's interest towards that particular area. So we will discuss how flower decoration can be used to enhance the indoor beauty. Now we shall discuss the principles of flower arrangement. Size should be appropriate to the room or other articles placed in the room. That is, there should be a uniform balance that has to be maintained. Plant materials should be proportionate to the size of the containers. Flower material should be 1.5 times higher than the height of the flower vase. Whole arrangement should look balanced. Keep the stem ends close together. Flowers should either be placed higher or lower than the curves of twigs. Allow space around each flower. The flowers, leaves, and vases should harmonize and complement each other. That is, both should go well together. For starting flower decoration, we need to understand certain terms that are required very frequently in making an arrangement. So first and very important thing is collection of materials. For collection of materials, we need to understand what all materials we require before starting flower decoration. First thing is vases. Vases of different sizes should be chosen so as to match the surrounding decor and mood of the surrounding area. Flowers of varying sizes should be chosen to break the monotony and increase interest. Natural looking artificial flowers can be used to give it a natural look. Natural leaves can also be used to increase the bulk and natural look. Pin holders and stems of flowers and leaves should be there. Oasis is used to absorb a lot of water and keep flowers moist. Twigs helps to enhance and give a natural look to the arrangement. Method for flower arrangement. What you need to do to make effective flower arrangement. First, you need to fix pin holder to the container and pour water into the container. Soak the foam or oasis in water till it is saturated and then place it in the vase. Decide the shape of the flower arrangement. You can make it in a triangle manner, right angle, oval shape, S shape, circular, and many more arrangements are available. This picture shows some of the arrangement of flowers. It also shows the shape as well as the different lines that are being used to enhance the beauty through the flower arrangement. Flower decoration is a decorative arrangement of flowers to enhance the beauty of the surrounding by keeping in mind the aesthetic aspect. It can be used both indoors as well as outdoors. It can be made into horizontal as well as vertical arrangement depending upon the purpose and the function for which it is being used. Choose 5 flowers of different sizes in one color. Cut the stems of flower at different length. Arrange the tallest flower first and then other flowers. Push the branch firmly inside a pin holder or an oasis to prevent its fall down. Add the flowers at different heights ensuring enough space in between so that there should be no clutter. Put bigger flower towards the bottom, medium size in the center, and birds at the top of the arrangement to keep it simple and light. Fill the gaps with appropriate leaves of different sizes. Hide the pin holder and oasis with leaves, stones, and any other thing. As you all know that flowers are used everywhere, be at home or outside. Wherever you go, whatever occasion it is, flowers are used everywhere to modify and beautify the surroundings. So we here are today going to show you how you can use various flower and other things to beautify the surrounding and how you can make innovative flower decoration. First, we will start with what all equipments you require for making flower decoration.
Before we actually start with the arrangement, I would like to discuss about the various materials which are used for making flower arrangement. There are various types of flowers which are available in market. These are seasonal flowers which are available at a very economical cost. Some of the flowers we have brought for demonstration. These are the flowers. Then there are some filler materials which are used, such as these are the leaves which we have, which are locally available in your garden or in your plants or pots. So these are some of the filler materials which we can use for filling up spaces. If the flowers are not available in the season, then you can also use these artificial flowers for making your flower arrangement. Along with these, there are various types of vases which are used for making flower arrangement. This is the vertical one which you can take for a taller flower arrangement. Then the vase such as this, made up of cane, this is easily available in market at your local florist. This one is a shallow vase which you can use for lower depth flower arrangements. Then you will also be requiring a cutter for reducing the size of your flowers or your leaves, scissors. Then some pins are here, such as this U-pin, which are easily available at home for joining two flowers together.
And we have the ropes as well to tie the flowers together, and the ropes we have used the brown color so that it can blend well with the stem and the green material of the flowers. Just to add to the names, this flower that we are using, it is calendula. This one is the phlox. This one, what we are doing is gladiole. And this is the chrysanthemum. So these are the flowers. And if we talk about the foliage, we have this cycas, we have the asparagus, and the other are just the foliage that we use to add to the bulk and the natural beauty of the flower arrangement. So let's first begin with our first arrangement, that is a vertical arrangement, and it is a Japanese type of arrangement. It is known as
ikebana.
Yeah.
So basically, ikebana is a Japanese art of flower arrangement. There are three elements which are used in ikebana. First is heaven. Heaven is the tallest one. Then the middle one is men, and the lowest one is earth. So to give height to your flower arrangement, we are going to use this leaf.
Yes.
Manisha.
Yes.
So
we will start our arrangement and let's see how it goes.
So this is a moss which you can get from your florist, and this is a dry moss. So what you can do is, if you will use a dry moss, it will easily break into parts. So before we actually start with our flower arrangement, you have to moist it with the help of water. So this is slightly bigger. We're going to cut it according to the size of our vase. And we also have to make sure that height of your moss should not exceed height of your vase. As you can see, Manisha,
yes,
this is a dry sponge, you can say, kind
yes
of a sponge form which you have, but it's a solidified
yes
one. So we are going to put little water in it to make it moist.
It will absorb the water and it will not become soggy, but yes, very spongy.
Yes, like this,
yes,
it will become moist. So we're going to place it in the center, and right now I don't have it, but you can use a iron wire to fix it at a particular place so that it do not get, you know, it do not break. Then we are going to place. Going to give it height with the help of this lead and we are going to put it in the center
like Pratima, this. You can show them how you have cut the edges of the
lead. Yes, yes, I forgot that. Basically this is the normal leaf which we took from our garden, and because it was quite big and the shape and the edge of this leaf was also uneven, so we cut it according to the height which is required. And actually about height, this is very, very important, you know, property, or we can say principle of flower arrangement, which we should not forget. The height of your flower arrangement should be according to the height of your vase. So as you can see, there is not much height in this pot. It is very shallow pot. So we are not going to calculate the height of our flower arrangement according to the height of the vase, but actually we are going to take width of this vase. So the height of this flower arrangement should be 1.5 times width of this vase. Accordingly, if we are using a taller vase like this one, so we are going to take height of our flower arrangement, height of the tallest flower in our arrangement, it should be again 1.5 times the height of the vase. So in this we have taken height of the flower according to the width of the vase. So this is the tallest leaf which we are going to take. This will signify our heaven state in Ikebana flower arrangement. Then the second stage we are going to depict. You can actually cut it according to the height which you want. And before you cut it, you have to actually see how much height you want. And in one go, we are not going to cut it on the top, from the top, because then the flower will get spoiled if that height is lesser than what we actually need. So we are going to cut it according to the height which we require, and little slant so that it is easier for us to put it in the moss. Like this we are going to put it. This will signify men, and then little smaller flowers to signify earth, which will be at the base of this flower arrangement. And again we are going to cut them according to the height which we need. Manisha, would you like to place few?
Yeah.
Can take this. We have to lower down these flowers a little bit to show a significant gap between the three elements. So as you can see, this is slightly bigger, so maybe we can take it out and, you know, cut its length a little bit. Okay, so our flower arrangement is somehow like this. These are the three elements: heaven, men, and earth. So this is somehow, it is going to look like this. And again, now as you can see, our moss is visible. So when you are making a flower arrangement, we also have to consider that this moss should not be visible. So to hide this moss, we are going to use some foliage. Like this. So we are not going to use it as it is, but we are going to take out some part of it and put it here.
So we will cover the entire moss with this foliage.
These you can use whatever is available in your garden, local material, any leaf, green leaves which are available. you can use them. Not necessary the same one which we are using you have to use, but any leaf you can use for covering your moss. Some you can also take, Manisha, if you would want. I'll give you. And these are very easy to make. Some little bit of your creativity and imagination, and it can turn out to be a beautiful flower arrangement. This is still coming out, so I'll decrease height of this flower.
Now we are going to show you the vertical arrangement, how you can make a flower decoration with a vertical arrangement. So we have the materials here. This is asparagus, this is sudarshan, and you already know the flowers that we have, that is chrysanthemum, this is phlox, this is gradula, and this is calendula. So now we will show you how we can make a vertical arrangement.
So using same flowers and same material, we can remodify our arrangement according to our taste and the occasion for which we are going to make it. So this time we are going, rather than using a shallow vase, we are going to use a vertical vase. So this time we are going to make height of our arrangement according to the height of our vase. So this is quite a bigger leaf. So we are going to cut it according to the height of vase. But before that, we are going to take this moss and moist it with the help of water.
We will put them and then we will put the water so that it gets moist. And meanwhile, we can clean our leaves and our flowers so that there could be no grim or dirt present in it.
Yeah, to clean dirt and to enhance its appearance. Yes. As Manisha said, we can clean it with the help of a cloth.
Yes.
And also, if you want to make it more glossy, you can use little bit of oil to increase its shininess.
Yes.
So now this has become moist, our moss. Now Manisha, we are going to use this leaf.
Yes.
And we are going to cut it according to the height of our moss.
Yes.
So when you are cutting it, you have to make sure to make it a little pointed so that it easily goes into the moss.
Pratima, we can cut from the top.
It is little big.
Okay.
So again, we are going to cut it. So okay, we are not cutting it in one go, so that we know we do not spoil our leaf.
Yes.
So we are going to cut it step by step and see it according to the height of our vase. See, Manisha, now?
Yes.
Now it is fine?
I think so.
Yes.
Yes, it's looking fine now.
We are going to take one more leaf.
Yes. We can work with it now.
And cut it also in this pointed form.
And you can keep the height same, or if you want to give some sort of a gradation, then you can decide the height accordingly. But now for our arrangement, we are keeping the height same.
Then, Manisha.
So now this is the foliage or the asparagus that we are going to put in the vertical form.
Yes. So you again, this also you can see the height. Basically, before this, we are going to place our flowers.
Yes.
And wherever,
yes,
the space is empty, we are going to fill it with the help of foliage.
So this type of arrangement you have to decide on your own, that how you want to put what first. So we are just trying What?
So these are the gladiolus which we are going to use. And before we actually start with the arrangement, one very important thing in our vertical arrangement, this is we are going to make a triangle shaped arrangement. So mm-hmm. in this arrangement or in any arrangement, what we have to be careful is we have to use odd number of flowers. So now we have four gladiolus. So instead of using four, we have to use three gladiolus because of bringing the balance and harmony in our flower arrangement. So we are going to take this gladiolus to give it a height, and we are going to cut it. I think Manisha, we need to cut it.
Yes, I think so.
So first of all, the first one we are going to put it in middle, like this. And the rest two will go accordingly, according to the height. We are going to lower down the height of our flower arrangement. This is slightly lower than the mid one. And third one, we are going to put this side.
Like
towards
this.
Your side, Manisha, you can, if you can help me.
Sure, Pratima. Okay, so this is like one flower we have placed. Now we will go to the next flower, keeping in mind the height and as well as the color contrast and color combination. We have to also keep in mind that all the colors will blend well and none of the color will get superseded or get superimposed over the other. So you have to keep that in mind as well.
So now we are going to use the third level of flowers.
And we are using white.
So every color will stand out on its own. We have used orange, we have used white.
And we can add this tinge of purple color just to add the interest. Like, because like we have the three tones that is going on in the color. So we can just add one, this purple tinge to add to the focal point or the emphasis. You can further prune and trim it according to the space where you are putting it, whether it is in the center or in the corner. So this is like one arrangement that we have made. Now we will discuss floor decoration. In India, floor decoration is the form of decoration that is widely being used. From very ancient time till today, floor decoration has taken many forms, but the original decoration techniques has remained the same. We decorate our floor by using some design, stencils and some other pictures, by using flowers, by using colors, powder colors, by using sawdust, even by using household materials like haldi, atta and many other colors that are available in the market, as well as the gulal that we commonly use in Holi festival, all are being used for decorating the floor. So what is the essence of floor decoration? In our culture, it is being said Atithi Devo Bhava. So to welcome our God or to welcome our guest, it is being made on the floor at the front gate of every house. For any auspicious occasion, for any other function, Indians always prefer to decorate their floor, and many Indians prefer to decorate it on everyday basis. We have religious content attached to this very basic concept of floor decoration. So what is floor decoration? It is a process of decorating floors by making different designs with the help of various colors and flower petals, which are widely known as Rangoli concept. Rangoli are generally made on the doorstep, courtyard or veranda of the house. So what are the main points that we have to consider while designing or deciding what floor decoration we want to give? Select design according to the theme of the festival or the occasion. Draw the design in double lines so that color and material can be filled in between. Ensure uniformity and balance throughout the design. Use contrasting colors next to each other. While filling, use a scale to neaten the outlines. Fill evenly. Press flat to smoothen the material. Fill the background so that the design looks part of the floor and not something outside. As you can see in this picture, there are some girls and ladies who are making rangoli in the near the door size or as well as in the center of the room according to the function and the purpose for which they are making. Now there are various designs and various forms of rangoli. Like if you go towards South India, you will see kolam, widely used floor decoration. If you go towards east, you can see alpana that we all make during the Diwali season, that is the feet of the Lakshmi that we all make. And when you go towards the north side, then you can see very vibrant colors and lot of colors included in making the rangoli in the shape of the peacocks or the wings of the peacocks, you know, fanning out. So these are the certain designs by which you can make a very attractive floor arrangement. Now we need to understand how to arrange the accessories. There are certain points that we need to understand before thinking of what accessories we want to use in our household environment. Hang paintings according to their size and space available, that is big paintings on the big wall and small paintings on the small wall. Paintings can be enhanced by putting spotlights which fall directly on the painting and will increase and enhance the beauty and the details of that painting. Hang all paintings straight and even and not lopsided, that is they should follow the uniform code of conduct throughout the wall. Color of the lamps should be harmonized with the entire decor of the house. Cushions can be placed randomly to add color and variety to the room.